Hello and welcome! One of my biggest fears while traveling with my portable gaming library is just losing any of my games on the road. It sadly happened to me at least once or twice where a game was lost in a relative's couch cushions or buried in a hotel bedsheet, never to be seen or found again. So as I'm traveling, I have to make decisions like which games to bring and which ones to leave behind, and that really doesn't make much sense to me. Why do I even need to make decisions like this in the first place? My Nintendo 3DS has 64 gigabytes of storage on it. Why can't I just take the game cards and put it onto the system itself? And I never will need to bring my 3DS or DS game cards ever again. Well, even though Nintendo says you can't do it, I hacked Nintendo 3DS and some software says you can. So today I want to show you how to back up and play not just Nintendo 3DS game cards, but also original Nintendo DS game cards on your Nintendo 3DS systems. But first, a message from us at 16-Bit. Today's video is sponsored by us at the 16-Bit Store. Organize and display your games and systems with our 3D printed display stands. They are designed and printed by us to fit your games and systems comfortably so they can be displayed beautifully. They're available now at the 16-Bit Store, so if you're interested, why not check them out from the links in the description. Before we begin, a bit of a legal disclaimer. You should only be backing up your Nintendo DS and 3DS game cards. You shouldn't be backing up your friends' games to use for yourself, or backing up your games and then selling the physical copies, because that means you don't technically have a license to use it, and as a result, you're pirating and it's illegal. If you want to learn a little more about the legality of backing up computer software and games, please watch our videos, Our Realms Are Legal, as it goes into more details than I'm willing to give here. And if you want to check out another video going over the same subject, please check out the extra credits videos. I'll leave the links for both of those in the cards or in the description below. So, in order to back up your Nintendo DS and 3DS game cards, what will you actually need? The first thing you're going to need is actually a hacked Nintendo 3DS with God Mode 9 and FBI, and if you want to play your DS games on your system, you'll be needing either a modern R4 card or the Twilight Menu +++ homebrew software. If you don't have a hacked 3DS, we have a guide to explain how to set that up if you need it. You'll also need your Nintendo 3DS and DS game cards, which you want to actually back up. Now that we have everything in order, let's begin by booting our Nintendo 3DS into God Mode 9 by powering on the system and immediately pressing and holding Start. Once booted into God Mode 9, we can back up our game cards. Put your game card into your 3DS system, and if it's already in, you'll need to take it out and put it back in order for God Mode 9 to recognize it. Once done, navigate down to C Game Card and press A, and you'll be presented a menu with all the options and the game files. And since I've inserted a Nintendo DS game, I'll show you how to back that up first. We'll need to look for the NDS file that's located somewhere on here. That's our unencrypted DS game. And to back it up, just press A on it and select Copy to GM9 out. Wait for the progress bar to finish, and congratulations! You've just backed up a DS game! And it's ready to use on whatever you'll like. And yes, if you see a .sav file there, that's your save data if you wish to back that up. Two, though the homebrew software Checkpoint or FBI is a little bit nicer and easier to use if you're backing up 3DS or DS games when you're not in God Mode 9. Now that we've backed up a DS game, let's go and back up a 3DS game card next. The first few steps are exactly the same as for a DS game card, but this time our game is located in the trim.3ds file. So press A on that and select the NCSD image options. Afterwards, select Build CIA from File and wait for the progress file to finish. This will create a CIA file which we can use to install our game to a Nintendo 3DS game system later. However, if you just wish to play your game cards on an emulator like RetroArts or Citra, and you don't really want to install your games on any system, just select the decrypt file option instead, and this will build you a .3ds file which can be run as is. And congratulations, you've just backed up your game cards. If you have more game cards, just press B to go back to the menu and switch your games around and start the process all over again. So now that we've backed up our game cards, what can we actually do with them? Well, with a 3DS CIA file, we can install our games onto our SD card with the help of FBI. So if you want to do that, just open FBI, go in the SD card option, look for the location of your backed up games. Mine's still located in the GM9L4. And once you found your games, just press A on it and install it. Also, don't delete it if you haven't backed up your game files to a computer, as you'll have to build a new CIA file if you do, and that does take a bit for some titles. As for DS games, you'll either need an R4 to play them on your system, or you'll need to install Twilight Menu++. And I find Twilight Menu++ just a little easier to use, so I'll be linking that below. Once you have the means to run DS game ROMs on your 3DS, just boot whatever software you're using, find the ROM you want to boot, and, well, have fun with it. And if you want to, just toss your 3DSX file or your DS file into any emulator and it should work. Just don't forget your save files. But anyways, that's how you go and back up your DS game cards. Thank you ever so much for watching. I do hope this guide helps you build your own games or makes it a little easier for you to bring your entire game library wherever you go. Hope you have yourself a good day, and as always, take care. And don't forget about the new poll available every Friday for the 16-bit viewer special. Vote for which games you want to see us review in our community tabs. Links will be provided below.